Hello, welcome to Markets by Mehta. So today's topic would be evergreen businesses and which all businesses you can invest in for getting the best returns and the safest returns. So let's go one by one. I'll start with my famous business, that is Jubilant Foodworks. And let's start with the returns, how much return it has given. So if you see the returns calculator, in 5 years the stock has given 374% returns. And why is it so? Let's explore. If you see the price is continuously increasing in straight line. So do you know what is Jubilant Foodworks business? It is running the chain of Domino's pizzas. Yes, it would be favorite for most of us. And even during this pandemic times, you would trust the Domino's more than anyone else. And the taste again is irreplaceable. So, and people would not stop going out and having this delicious pizza. So yes, this is an evergreen business, a classic example of evergreen business wherein the company will never make loss because always people are interested in eating junk food and the taste. So yeah, this is one of the example of Jubilant Foods. And if you see the financials, the balance sheet, it resonates with the stock price. It will keep on increasing continuously the revenue. And even if you see the profit and loss, again the profit, I think this is due to COVID, but the profit keeps on increasing day by day. So this is one of the evergreen business that you can say that it will never stop earning. And second would be, let's say, HUL. I would put it Hindustan Unilever. So Hindustan Unilever, as you know, it has whole range of products. It will keep on growing continuously. I mean, it manufactures a lot of shampoos and soaps and different. So you can find it here in if you go to company. And it manufactures soaps, detergent, shampoos, skincare, toothpaste, deodorants, cosmetic, tea, coffee. These are the things that are exhaustible goods, and people would need it once they are perished. So some of the big brands are Lux, Lifebuoy, Surf. You will need it. You'll need these things in your day-to-day life. So this is again a evergreen investment stock when you will never see that company will make loss. So if you see the growth, it is a continuous growing company. So it is also called as fast moving consumer good or FMCG firm. Let's go to DMart. I know many of you would be having the stock in your watch list. So if you see DMart, it was, I think the IPO price, the price at which it came into the market was 300, and now it opened at 600, and now it is almost 2800. And the graph would be, it was here almost 700. It's continuously growing. Why? Because DMart has an exclusive franchise of stores. It offers a wide range of products. Almost it sells almost everything, right from grocery to food items and stuff. And if you see the fundamentals too, again this the financial, this will resonate. The balance sheet keeps on growing continuously with over a period of time. So this is again an evergreen stock. Next evergreen stock would be IRCTC, I would prefer, because again IRCTC is the railways kind of private company which caters ticketing service and even the food on rail. So if you see the fundamentals, this is very interesting. The balance sheet keeps on growing continuously, and due to its monopoly, people will be having only one way to book their ticket, that's IRCTC. So there is no new company that is going to come into this area, and it's a professionally run company. So yeah, again, this is an evergreen investment, and people will not stop traveling, and railways are the heart of Indian travels due to its economical and sustainable benefits. So this is again an evergreen stocks, and if you see the returns, the stock has given very good return. It was almost 900 here, and I think it was given the same price as DMart, 300 to 400, and now it's 1700 due to its monopoly business. So yeah, this is also evergreen business that one can invest in. Okay, any other, there is also a company, Nestle. I am not a fan, big fan of this company, but you can consider this as evergreen business due to its, again, FMCG nature and perishable good. It sells a host of food products, like Maggi is a household name, right from the, if you go on a trek in Himachal or in Himalayas, you will find Maggi, and it is also available in the South India and also in villages. So these are the whole range of products people keep on eating, and this company keeps on growing. So yeah, this is again a permanent business that anyone can think about, and it need not worry about the demand or any of the competition, because it is an established brand and people will need these companies to survive. So how do you find a company which is having these characteristics? So one is, if the revenue of the company does not fall, let's say here you go to financials, and if the revenue doesn't fall and it's not dependent on any of the market conditions, and it is selling a product which is having a very low competition, and people are in love with that company, so then we would consider it as an evergreen stock. Let's say, for example, Adani Transmission, one of my senior investor colleague told me when 5 years back, when he took this stock at around 5 to 6 years back, around 50 rupees he took the stock. So he was a senior citizen, and he told me that even if the power rates go up and down, even if the power consumption increases or decreases, you will need transmission, and to transfer the power from the power generation plant to the power consumption facility. So this is a permanent business. I mean, you don't need to get dependent on the demand and supply stuff. It's always the transmission that has to happen. So again, this is a permanent business, you can see, and it's reflected in the financials. The revenue keeps on growing completely. So again, people will need electricity for their daily consumption. Only difference between the electricity generators and transmitters are, generators may face some issues related to raw material or maintenance. But here, the transmission business, it's less capital intensive, and it's always in need. Speaking of transmission business, we can also search for similar business of gas transmission. We can say Indraprastha Gas. Indraprastha Gas provides gas facilities in Delhi and across the region. So people will keep on cooking. Demand is not going to fall. And again, the company helps in transmitting the gas from gases door to door. So this is again also an example of evergreen business. Also, it pays healthy dividends because it doesn't need any more capex to operate its current investment regime. So if you see the fundamentals, the demand always keeps on growing. Financials, this is a very beautiful graph. Year on year, the demand keeps on growing. In 2016, it's 3,000 crores turnover, and 2020, it's 7,000 crores turnover. So ideally, the stock should double. If the turnover doubles, the stock also doubles. And if you see the technicals, stock has already doubled, more than doubled. So this is how the evergreen stock works. So again, this is the gas line of Delhi. Mahanagar Gas operates in Bombay, and Gujarat Gas operates in Gujarat. So this is the concept of evergreen stocks, wherein you will never make losses unless and until there is an extreme change in management or extreme scams coming out. Let's say Coffee Day. Again, this was an evergreen business, but because the owner passed away and there were some small scams involved, so this stock has taken a hammer. So while it was trading at 350 rupees, and people, it's a CCD is a very household name. People go and chill in that place. Even in corporate offices, they have CCD machines. But due to the management fallout, the stock gave negative returns, and it's on the verge of bankruptcy as per media reports. So yeah, but there are very small chances, 1 or 2% of chances, wherein you will lose money, or else it's a stable demand companies. So yeah, just when you select the company, make sure it's evergreen.